Without a PID or a thermometer in your boiler, or even better, in your group, it's very difficult to predict your brew temperature. Many people serve the temperature, but what is temperature surfing? And how can I improve the temperature control in my shots? Well, I mapped the temperature in the boiler and in the puck, and in this video, I'm gonna show you how you can improve your shots without a PID. This is part of my studies to have more data to compare a Gaggia Classic off the shelf against a Gaggia with a PID and a Gaggiino. If you want to know how to install a PID, I have two videos with the theory and practice in Aurentilio Silvia. I'll put a card here and I'll also leave the links in the description in case you're interested. And later I'll also post a video about how to install the PID in a Gaggia Classic as well. But why temperature control is important? Higher temperature will lead to over-extraction, and low temperature will lead to under-extraction. Then your coffee may be sour if the temperature is too low, or bitter if the temperature is too high. If you like to try different beans, especially the fruity, fermented, the modern coffee, light roasts, in espresso, this can be the difference between the great cup and an okay-ish one. After adjusting all the other parameters like grind size, ratio, pre-infusion, temperature control can be that final touch that will make your cup maybe perfect for you. And if you are obsessively trying to find your perfect cup, you need data, you need consistency, and this world is very subjective, but a PID can give you at least some objective information about your extraction. So temperature control is important for me for three main reasons. One is predictability. I want to know what is the initial temperature and the final temperature when I'm brewing. Second is consistency. I can always brew my coffee at the exact temperature that I tried the day before, for example. And the third is temperature stability. If I have a PID, it will actuate in my heating element with 1 degree variation from my target temperature. If I have a thermostat, it will take maybe 5-10 degrees to actuate. This tends to give more stability in the cup, and it's also more comfortable because I can just sit and let the temperature stabilize and then I brew my shot. When we don't have a PID, we need to serve the temperature. And this is what I'm going to show here. If we don't have a PID, what can I do? As I mentioned, I'm preparing this second-hand machine to receive a Gaggiino, and I also wanted to compare this machine with PID against the Aurentilio Silvia with PID and against the same machine without the PID. Then I already had the PID controller, I already had the thermocouple, then I decided to remove the steam thermostat and put the thermocouple there so that I can use this PID as a thermometer. So here I'm measuring the temperature in the boiler, and I mapped what is the real temperature in the boiler when the light goes on, off, how long it takes for the light to go on and off, and what is the temperature, what is the curve of temperature in between, and how I did that. After replacing the steam thermostat by the thermocouple and connecting to the PID, I set the offset to zero so that I could measure the real temperature, and I recorded some cycles of heating with the lights going on and off to see what are the temperatures measured here. Then I discovered that the light goes off when the temperature achieves 107 degrees and the light goes on when the temperature achieves 103 degrees. And in between, it will reach up to 126 degrees, because when the heating element is triggered, it will continue delivering heat to the boiler even after it is deactivated. But I brought here only the critical data, so stick with me because I'm gonna show you only what is the most relevant information out of this recording that I made, okay? What do you need to know? When the temperature drops to 103 degrees, the light goes off and the machine starts heating. It takes 15 seconds to achieve 107 degrees. Then the light will go on. It will continue heating until 126 degrees. And then it will decline to 103 again, but it will take 4 to 5 minutes to achieve 103 degrees, and then the light will go off again. These are the important information that you need to have in mind. The second batch of information that is very relevant is the temperature in the puck. So I measured the temperature in the puck, and how I did that? I prepared a puck like I do for any espresso that I would extract. There's real coffee in the portafilter. Then I put a thermocouple inside this portafilter and I lock it in the group to start measuring the temperature. So when the light went off, I started a shot, took the data, then I repeated when the light went on. Exactly at the time that the light went on, I started another shot and I took the measurements. Those are real extractions, as I said, 25 seconds, 40 grams out. This is the standard that I try to use to be able to compare my experiments. And if you want to replicate this experiment, I'll leave the link for this thermometer and for the thermocouple that I use. Then you can do those tests at your home as well. It's super cheap, it's about 5 euros. And you can buy on Aliexpress. And what I discovered, when I start a shot immediately after the lamp goes off, the initial temperature in the puck is 92 degrees. And during the extraction, it will lose about 5 degrees. If I put a shot right after the lamp goes on, this machine is super hot. The water, the initial temperature of the water in the puck will be 100 degrees. It will also lose about 5 degrees during the extraction, but to my view, it's super hot. And this is the most important information if you want to serve the temperature in a Gaggia, okay? Because I know that if I start pulling the shot immediately after the lamp goes off, the initial temperature will be 92. But if it's when the light goes on, it's 100. So this 15 seconds difference will give me 8 degrees difference in the initial temperature. Then maybe I can wait 4 seconds, for example, to start brewing at 94 degrees. And then if I try my coffee and it's a bit sour, I would wait a couple of seconds more next time. And if it's bitter, I'll wait a couple of seconds less. And then I can adjust the coffee with a little bit of consistency. If you have another machine, you can use the same methodology with a thermometer or not. If you don't have a thermometer, you can use this strategy of waiting a few seconds between lights on and off to start pulling your shot and then adjust by taste. You can also do some search in the web about temperature surfing. There are different practices, but I wanted to bring some data for you to play. And remember that those measurements can differ depending on which model of Gaggia you have, and also the experiment and the instruments, they have their limitations and imprecisions. But I wanted to bring some data, at least for you to have an indication of what's going on in your machine and to give you the rationale for you to serve the temperature in your machine. So if you think that this video was beneficial, hit the like. And if you have other ideas on how to serve the temperature, leave in the comments for my learning and for the benefit of other viewers. And if you don't have a PID yet, consider viewing those other videos that I have on PID installation, and subscribe to receive the notifications about the PID installation in this Gaggia Classic and also the Gaggia Mod.